This is Keepsakes, the podcast. I'm Jay Agonoy.
Good day! It's the 25th episode of the Keepsakes podcast, and I am with the executive editor, am I correct?
Yes!
Executive editor of Anime Pilipinas, Melegrito. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
All right. So on this episode, we are here somewhere in just near his place, and we're talking about and with his iconic laugh, we will talk about Anime Pilipinas in 2019 and Shonen Jump. Of course, I'm still waiting for the conversation to happen. But then again, who knows? I'm still waiting. It's like I just want to hear these words. This is the conversation on Anime Pilipinas. ganun eh. Of course, those things sometimes run on my mind. So what do you think?
Well, what I can say is I'm definitely busy with the website. A lot more news are happening somewhere else, not on television, but mostly online. So things are, as one person that I know always say to me, 2019 is definitely going to be interesting, and it is, from streaming, from television, and manga, and you could see them a lot, places. Ang dami ng choices. Hindi lang po, wag lang puro legal. Kaya why choose something na for free na hindi mo naman alam mo naman na hindi susuportan ng industriya. So 2019 is definitely going to be interesting, so we will see, and it's just the start.
Okay, so in 2018, we have realized the birth of J-Novel Club is basically the light novel, online legal light novel service. And then now, after that, before the year ends, Shonen Jump has released its service online. It's a new Shonen Jump. It's still Shonen Jump, but it is a new Shonen Jump catered to the international audience. So can you tell me more about that?
Yes, as you may have known, the Viz Media has started Shonen Jump in 2002 as a print service. But as we all know, due to the decline of the print platform, they had transformed the monthly Shonen Jump that we all know before as into a weekly online digital magazine service since 2012, where it became weekly na sinasabayan nila kung paano mag-release in Japan. They are releasing it the same day as it is being released in the US. And I am pretty sure only a few people know about this, but in 2016, they actually included the countries Singapore, India, and the Philippines sa kanilang territories of service. Kaya nga kung mapapansin ninyo, there are Viz Media titles on fully booked and probably national bookstore somewhere. Kasi bihira lang makikita, pero I think meron na
papadaan. I believe there are some, if not Viz Media, is Kadokawa. Kodansha.
Kodansha
Comics.
Kodansha. So yun, as you know, yun, kung mapapansin niyo, Philippines is a part of Viz Media's territory. Starting last month, or as we say, December last year, Viz Media has decided to evolve Shonen Jump into another thing. Instead of making it as a weekly thing na babayaran mo subscription per month about 150 something per year, they have decided to make it into a digital service where catalog of weekly Shonen Jump titles will be available to you for free. Mga latest chapters to mga titles, you could read it for the week as it is being released in Japan, and you could also pay a monthly fee para mabasa mo lahat ng catalog, almost lahat ng catalog, not lahat ah, dahil from what I believe, there are titles na medyo reluctant yung mga creators na i-release yung kanilang mga titles digitally. Slam Dunk, Hunter, ata wala pa digitally. So but almost all titles, Dragon Ball, My Hero Academia, may Haikyuu One Piece. Oh, lahat ng One Piece imamarathon read mo.
So that's ano, that's for free or with subscription?
For subscription. Pero yung mga latest chapter, you could read it for free.
Alright. So, a lot of Shonen Jump titles are on display and can be read.
Shueisha specifically.
All Shueisha titles. All Shueisha titles. So
almost all.
Almost all. So that includes We Never Learn. Actually, yan yung una kong binabasa. Tobi, ano, as soon as I got my subscription to that service, Shonen Jump on Viz, I have We Never Learn. And hindi ko pa siya tapos. I'm on chapter 8, 17. Ayan, magsisimula pa lang sa chapter 17. It's really fun, no? But we go back before we leave everyone behind. Why is this important in the Filipino audience? For the Filipino audience in the Filipino context, bakit importante to?
I believe it is important that we support this new Shonen Jump service is because we mapapakita mo na we are directly supporting the industry and you could read it with quality, hindi yung mga tulad ng mga scanlations na medyo madudumi parang halatang na-scan or kung saan nakuha. And for even for just a small amount, $1.99, that is just about
120 pesos.
No, 105 pesos.
As of the exchange rate.
Yes.
So that is just a half or three.
Kalate lang yun ng mga kalate lang yun mga presyo ng mga conventions.
Mga tig sa conventions. So that's aside from that, since this is Shonen Jump, one of the best-selling books, titles, and ito talaga household name na ito. So we understand that this is a very important time in our lives, and this is a very very important for all the manga fans kasi dati diba
because ito rin napapansin ko eh especially sa Maynila, yung mga especially sa U-Belt, habang walang klase yung mga estudyante, some people play games, some people do their homework, but some people read manga, and most of them read something like One Piece,
Bleach, Naruto, okay,
Bleach, Naruto,
Dragon Ball. Lahat ng may na, pati Gintama na nandiyan.
Gintama, yes.
Especially Gintama. So lahat ng minensyon na Gintama dyan, Dragon Ball, please. It's right there. And if you pay around 105 pesos, I believe they made it so affordable that they discard, kumbaga parang they discarded the, okay, kasi the future is digital talaga. Yes. The future is mobile. The future is the phone. These words are already there. Eh. But that fact is already there. So in such an important time, na before we realize the anime streaming services that are legal, I'm just waiting. In this case, for example, hindi ko mapapanood ng The Promised Neverland except if I'm watching on Ani Plus.
Yes.
But if I go here to Shonen Jump, kung gusto ko talaga malaman story, I will go to Shonen Jump and then read the manga itself.
Yes.
So, kung hindi
masyadong and for a fuller context, syempre I'm pretty sure sa anime, the stories will be short and there will be some shortened sequence. I'm pretty sure if babasahin mo yung manga, mas kompleto, mas fuller ang laman nito, magiging laman nito.
At least pwede ko na siyang basahin kasi it's ongoing right now.
Yes.
And I believe it's coinciding with the anime series.
Yes.
So, in that context, kung hindi ka if you are really strictly going to the legal route and you can't watch this specific series, if it's a Shonen Jump title, you might want to read it.
If it's a Shueisha title, it will be on the Shonen Jump service.
Yun. So I think that's the importance of it, ano? And if you just listen to this, and you just realized that, go get the subscription. Paymaya pwede dito, di ba?
Yes.
Paymaya. You can just use your Paymaya virtual card.
Paymaya, and then, GCash, yes.
Di ba? So, at the time...
Actually, there are two options. There are two options. Visa, MasterCard, Amex, at saka PayPal.
PayPal. Pero, wag na yung PayPal. Mawalang galang na po sa PayPal. Most artists are having problems with PayPal.
Oh, yeah.
Pero, so yeah, we will have to ditch PayPal. PayPal will be like a gateway.
Yeah.
It's still our trusted gateway, pero nope. Nope. If possible, don't store your money there.
Lalo na yung dagdag fee nila, hindi ko maintindihan kung
yes.
Ano ba talaga yung percentage na kinukuha nila?
Yes, I donate to Flastas via PayPal with friends. So, at least hindi man ako yun okay pa yun eh.
Mm-hmm.
Pero yung the fact that you're doing illustrations, commissions and all that, tapos biglang i-hold ni PayPal lahat.
Oh.
Ng pera na nasa account mo.
Jesus.
And you will be having a problem how to retrieve it or whatnot. Masisira yung holiday mo, masisira yung ano mo.
Pass. At saka wala kang kikitain. Oh, no.
That's... But you're a fan artist and you do these things to either satiate yourself from for your to at least paano ba to? To at least enjoy mo yung pagiging fan mo, or you want to earn cash.
Kaya I could understand that most people really go for either Patreon or the coffee.
Even cosplayers go to coffee nowadays. Patreon is parang okay,
that is the tier.
So if you're the lowest tier, you go to PayPal. Second tier, coffee. Third tier, Patreon. Pero in terms of convenience, siguro maraming cosplayers ang nasa coffee ngayon, edi I'll go to coffee if possible. Pero we go back to Shonen Jump, yun nga no, there these payment options at the time where payments in the Philippines are getting much and much easier thanks to the digital financial innovations, financial technology, fintech. Maraming fintech services ngayon, so there are options.
Plus, before ka we charge for that fee, 7-day free trial. There's 7-day free trial para ma-check mo kung okay ba talaga sa'yo. Kung hindi, pwede mo i-cancel. Pero I'm pretty sure hindi mo kailangan i-cancel dahil because the titles are good. All of them are readable, even the new titles. Nivellation, it is really an interesting title.
Sino ba yung gumawa niya? Sino ba yung
Neolation.
So, sino ba yung ano niyan? Is that from a... I think may bagong si Hiromashima eh, but it's not that, right?
No.
So, that's Shonen Jump. And, of course, it's not that we're being shills, no? Pero, God, if... we just had to cut that shilling you short kasi this is a fact. Shonen Jump can now be read online. You don't need to suffer getting copies, physical copies of Shonen Jump delivered. You don't need
You don't need those weird scanlations na punong-puno naman ng ads at saka virus.
Te-trigger yung mga scanlation sites na because that's where they earn money too. Because that's the truth. Content is business. It's the age of content. It's the age of stories. Content is cash. So all of this content, eto na, this is a golden trove of content. We're not kidding. And we are members, subscribers of this service, can vouch for that.
So, yung tipong mababasa mo yung buong Blue Exorcist, Tokyo Ghoul Re. Yeah.
All of the Shueisha titles, Shonen Jump.
Food Wars, Crocus Basketball.
Food Wars! Ano pa ba meron dyan? We never learn. Demon Slayer.
Black Clover.
Si Asta.
Jojo's.
Jojo's, anong Jojo's yan? Kasi maraming Jojo's.
Yeah, daming Jojo's.
Maraming Jojo's.
I think lahat ata ng Jojo.
So yun. ShonenJump.com.
Yes, ShonenJump.com.
Alright, so... with that, we'll take a break, and I'm going to mention a few events that I will be attending to. So I'm getting my calendar ready.
Keepsakes, the podcast.
On January 13, Sunday, we will have the Anime Idol Convention at the Bayanihan Center. This is on a Sunday, and I will be there all day to get the story behind what is this. Prior to this, I featured Icon in the page, and I featured as well cosplay Matsuri. So sinabay ko na yon. I've met with the people of Icon, and they're good people. I believe this is a promising event, because then again, the fans are already the fans are asking for such event like this. So if you're not here, I don't know what are you doing, especially if you're an anime idol fan. Aside from Love Live, Idol Master, we have here Idolish 7. Hindi lang itong mga catered sa male audience. There's also series catered to the female audience. The Project and all that, so on and so forth. There's also Artist Ali, and there are performances including but not limited to Dreamcatchers. They were the ones who performed as front act for the Jam concert on Cosplay Mania's 10th anniversary sa Jam concert noong day 2, if I'm not mistaken. No, day 1, Dreamcatchers. And Alice Project, ang pinakakilalang alyansa ng mga Moe Idol girl group sa Pilipinas. So that's Anime Idol Convention in a nutshell. And yes, Do It For The Idols will be there. So magwawala kami dyan. Yet Taiga, 5OY pa. Yakay des. So from the morning up to the night of January 13, I will be seeing you at the Bayanihan Center in Pasig City. We will be there. So next event natin is Otaku Expo, which will be happening on February 2 and 3 at SM Mega Mall Mega Trade Hall. Next event natin, Cosplay Carnival 2019. This will be at SMX on March 23. On April 6, Ozine Fest 2019. April 6 and 7, SM Mega Mall. And May 4, Saturday, Black Ink Manga Fest. June is the Toycon month, 28 to 30 of June at SMX Manila. And August, hinihintay pa natin yung date for the 10th anniversary ng Best of Anime, no? 10th anniversary na? 10 taon na ang BOA? Parang kailan lang. And September, Cosplay Mania 2019. September 28 to 29, 2019, SMX Manila. October, wala pa tayong nakaschedule event for October, no? December 14, wait. December 12. Tinitignan ko na yung mga calendars. Ano, yung mga
baka work calendar na
yun. Hindi, birthday calendar to. December 26, 27, Ozine Fest Anime Figure Special 2019. December 28 to 30, Cosplay Matsuri 2019. So that's the event calendar so far, and kinuha ko to from Anime PH, from various sources. So they have that list, and yeah, looking forward to see you in these events. Halos one event per month eh.
Keepsakes, the podcast.
Alam naman natin ng Pilipinas eh. Mm. Para there will always be an event per month. Kaya some people, kaya I could understand that some people would think that it is tiring. Which I could understand. Mm. Because parang ano, sa daming oras sa mundo, daming oras na may parating may event, parang ang daming there's a lot of things that you expect to be here, pero parang ang hirap i-divide ng oras.
True.
But yeah.
Okay, so yeah, welcome back to the podcast. I'm still with JM Melegrito. He's the executive editor for Anime Pilipinas.
Yo.
And kumusta ang ano, ang transition? Now, by the way, congratulations sa brand transition ano. They've just had a brand change this year. Kailan pa kayo huli nagbago ng brand?
2 years ago, actually.
2 years ago.
Yung web, our current website was just is just about a year, mga ganun. Mm. Pero the last rebrand was 2 years ago. We just want to take things a lot more serious now with the new logo. Mm,
so
just for the record, the logo doesn't really mean anything. We just really want to make things a lot more edgy. We just want to be more serious to people. Kasi ang weird nung, I must admit, ako yung gumawa ng unang logo. Mm. And it just looks too corny. Kaya parang even I would think na parang wow, I definitely need a change. So yeah, matagal namin na pag-usapan namin ito ng mga kasama ko and they're definitely satisfied. Though I admit we will do a lot more. Medyo may mga aayusin pa kami sa websites and other stuff and we definitely would like to add a lot more content. Kasi yun yung nagiging drive ngayon kaya nag-rebrand kami. Mm. Is to want to bring more, a lot more to people. Mm. Whether it's news, opinions, and everything else.
So dadating pa ba yung The Conversation?
We are trying a lot of things, but we are focusing a lot more on the website because we want to show more of our we want to be more flexible kung anong gagawin namin sa website na we would like to see kung mas marami bang balita from overseas or talagang strictly local, kung kailangan ba namin magsulat ng opinion post every month. We are trying a lot of things, so
So yun. Then again, you're currently at your transition, ano? This is the point of transition, ano?
Yes.
So hindi pa tapos ang lahat.
Pinag-usapan ba namin yung mga kasama ko kung paano yung plano?
Oh, ayan. And looking forward to that kasi it's 2019 already and things
are 5 years na.
5 years na ang Anime Pilipinas. Ah, congratulations, 5 years. Magpa-5 years na kayo. Ayan. Mm. From the time as Zen, ilang taon na ba since natatag ang Zen? It's around 2004? 7?
The forums, I think, just started in about 2005, something.
2005. So from 2005 to 2015
tapos
to 2018.
Then I think it's 2005-2006. Then the main website, yung Zen Honbu website, started in about 2009-2010.
Hmm. Ang dami din natin pinagsamahan. Kaya this is why I'm still with all of you guys at Anime Pilipinas. Kahit na nagkakandaleche-leche din tayo minsan. But then again, looking forward to that, ano? So,
thanks.
Moving back dun sa ating, since I mentioned the events earlier, events calendar,
yes.
Sabi ko nga, almost one event every month.
Yes.
Minsan pa nga nag-overlap, there are 2 events. For example, sa June, mayroong event na
minsan nag-overlap pa yung mga tulad ng ESGS,
yes.
Asia Pop Comic Con.
Yes, there was that time eh. Buti na lang, at least the organizers now are aware na hindi pwede magsabay yung isang event sa isang event because mahahating audience mo.
Yes.
And that's from an event professional. I'm taking it from me as an event professional. Professional. I still have
Naalala ko pa rin nung nag-overlap ang history ko na tsaka Best of Anime kasi lalong nagtiwala yung audience.
Ang pinaka-naalala ko yung 2015. Best of Anime and Asia Pop Comic Con. That's the time na ano, even for me, it took a toll on my body, so you know what happened. Pero moving back, let's talk about this story from the Reimaru Files.
Yes.
This feature on Confatigue. So, yes, I understand that there is a Confatigue.
Yes.
I understand that there is such content na people experience around the same time, around the same experience, no? And I understand that as one of the panelists there, na-explain natin yung struggle ng on the side of being an event staff, event organizer. Kasi sometimes hindi na-explain yung condition ng events organizer. Even to disclose, even Chad, the founder, yes, is himself with the Riot Concepts,
yes,
which
handles
is ESGS. So dito nag-overlap yung mga disclosures namin eh. Pero during that time siguro sa ESGS, Chad was off the hook eh. And he has his team, so that's fine. At least off the hook. Parang si Doreza lang yan ng Mindanao Times eh. He's off up eh. Now he's back at Mindanao Times, I believe, kasi wala siya sa off up eh.
Sa office, he resigned.
He resigned from the Office of the Presidential Advisor on Peace Process. So, yun. Mabalik tayo. I believe you have seen the story about that, the statistics so far.
Yes.
And of course, I do share some sentiments, ano, on a populist statement, on a populist stand, I do share the same sentiments, some of the same sentiments nung story na there's this content and this, it's like every time na every event, every month, it's the same experience all over again. Eating contest, singing contest, throwing contest, artist alleys, cons, cosplays, boots, merchandise. Probably, pero that's, ano eh, there are different perspectives on this.
Yes.
I want to hear your perspective on this.
In my personal opinion, not the opinion of my organization, I do think that there is such thing as a fatigue, but it varies through different factors. Alam naman natin kung saan nangyayari ang mga events. One is either at Mega Mall, mostly it's on
SMX.
The problem is saan nanggagaling yung mga tao. Kung mala, especially dito sa
mga East Boys, mga kapwa East Boys.
Yung dadaanan pa yung LRT, tapos MRT, yung makikipagmandirig mga kapwa sa mga maraming tao. Yun yung medyo nakaka-stress. One factor yun na if you're far from the event, pero yun lang yung yun lang talaga yung event na gusto mong puntahan. It kind of takes a toll. Another thing in my opinion would be that yung pare-pares lang talaga yung nangyayari. Yung pare-pares lang yung nangyayari. Walang masyadong differentiation na ang offering nila is the eating, the cosplay, the screening, and all such. Naisip ko na lang na sometimes they blend all together. Parang, wow. Iba-ibang events to pero it's all the same. Parang, it's a bit stressful. And then there is also a factor of bata of the age or nagtatrabaho ka. Talagang mahirap. Talagang mahirap na madami kang kunwari may anak ka na, may anak ka, tapos parang you're still into the pop culture, pero you have now that sense of responsibility na magulang na ako or may trabaho ako, so medyo mahirap na event. So there's also that factor of fatigue. So in my personal opinion, kaya medyo I could understand yung survey na ginawa ng Reimaru ni Chad at iba pa. I could appreciate, pero I think they could have gotten more people to do the research, and they could have at least go deeper dun sa ginawa nilang research para talagang mas kumpleto yung perspective.
Your challenges in creating surveys of such, kasi if we're talking about statistics right here, the convenience of the person who will be answering it, the privacy, of course, there's a data, yes, privacy act. Of course, taking into consideration all of those things, kasi those are the things na, kumbaga, essential yan, pero we're talking about the topic itself. We're talking about this,
yes,
topic of convention event statistics, and sabi ko nga, there are different perspectives on this. One is of the cosplayer. Kung cosplayer ka, you went there to cosplay, to have fun, to meet friends,
yes,
to bond with people. It's okay.
Yes.
It's really okay. But it's just the purpose of bonding it. at the same time, you also have this perspective of, ah, siksikan yung mga ano dito, maraming tao dito. Why not we go to photo shoots? Mm. And these things are happening as we speak. Mm. And these things are, kumbaga, this is the, ano eh, kumbaga, ang first tier mo, cosplay conventions, second tier, photo shoots, third tier, you're going overseas somewhere else, and the, ano eh, there's this tiering dyan eh. Can't we help? Mm. Sometimes, you have to apply the caste system, no? Kasi sabihin na, pwede ka maging, you can be in the caste or outcast ka or whatnot, no? But, there's really this hierarchy. Mm. Ano, that's what I want to explain.
Kaya to be honest talaga. Mm. Going to a convention overseas talagang it brings you different perspective on things. Mm-hmm. I've attended AFA for 2 times and talagang every year talaga there's something really different na nangyayari, and I'm pretty sure na ang daming nangyayari nung nagpunta
ka. Yes. AFA 29, C3 AFA Singapore 2018. Blink and you will miss it. Yun yung pinakabuod nung ano eh. Blink and you will miss it. A lot of activities have been happening. Of course, it's the 10th year anniversary of AFA. Hindi ko pinalampas yun. Same with others who went there. Ang dami pumunta ngayon. This 2018. Because simply, it's the 10th year anniversary of AFA. And most of us who can't afford to go to AFA have now jobs, can't afford it. And from what I understood, I overheard this during OZine eh, na may mga ano, sa sobrang mga dami mga bagong tao ngayon, there are new people. Uh-huh. So, we the old guys are going to be replaced by the new guys. Maybe there's a different kind of appreciation right there. Maybe. Hindi lang sa perspective ng eventers who's aiming for the content itself. Hindi lang sa perspective ng merchandisers na gustong makabenta. Hindi lang gusto lang ha, gustong makabenta. At the same time, ma-enjoy yung event. And at the same time, perspective ng congoers na baguhan and yung mga veterano na mga
kasi in my from what I see personally not my organization again not my organization from what I see the loudest voices in the room are yung mga medyo may pagka mataas ang expectations, mataas ang bank account or mababa yung bulsa sa barya, ay bulsa sa pantalon. Parang yun sila yung mas may, to be honest, sila yung parang mas may ingay. Parang mas gusto kong marinig yung perspective rin ng mga umaaligid lang, yung mga those who totally just enjoy the events. Mm-hmm.
So, you know, those are really many things na, no, I considering all these things, considering all these matters, siguro yun nga, that's one thing that we need to consider if we are going to do another survey. And I respect Chad and the Reimaru Files for bringing this up to attention. We are now opening to a discussion about content, and I'm glad to be part of that discussion as well. So, mahaba pang discussion to. We might have a part 2 with this, pero wala pa tayo makikita ng conclusion. It's already the start of the year. It's time for us to think about the things that we needed to sort out as we try to get an answer. A conclusion, kumbaga,
yes,
sa kung ano ba tong confatigue. Because this is, okay, confatigue is just a term.
Yes. That someone convoluted na it's a term.
Mm. Pero moreover than that,
but I think it's really more than fatigue.
It's either nasa on my perspective ba? Ako patanda na, ako inahabol na ako ng panahon. Of course, hindi ko na kaya magtatakbo-takbo here and there. Tumatanda na rin ako, nawawala na rin ako ng gana sa, for example, mga kakwelahan, mga kadiri subs, mga taggrupo Tako Only Knows, Anime Corner Group Pilipinas. Really, really. There's just a lot of things at my hand. And of course, at the end of the day, I will still be at my circle of friends. So, I remember one time, I tried to expand my reach. I tried to make an initiative. Sinuporta naman to ng ilan, pero at the end, wala naman nangyari because you can't. If you're, I know my place.
Mm-hmm.
I know my capacity. So, hindi ko pwede pag-unite lahat ng mga tao. What I can only do is to get these people to interact with each other and then let's see where this goes. Kumbaga parang networker ang dating pero ano, hindi pang MLM.
Ika nga ng isang meme. We grew up to become Squidward.
Totoo. We grew up to become Squidward. Totoo yan, actually. So, it's either that or we just need to get the voice of a new generation.
Yes.
A new generation of people who are anime fans. A new generation of anime fans. Well, it's basically like, oh, we're the news generation. There's the Apo generation. There's the Snow generation. Ang dami nating sinasabi dito, but then, bottom line.
Abangan ng PDP.
Abangan ng susunod na kabanata. Bottom line here is that this is yet the start. The start of everything that we will discuss about the whole event content. Of course, event organizers, event visitors, event people, so on and so forth. It will be long. And then there will be Toycon, there will be Cosplay Mania. Of course, disclosure, no? I'm with Team Toycon. Toycon, Cosplay Mania, Best of Anime, yung mga lumaki na sa atin na ano, even Ozin, they are household names.
Oh, dami pa rin pumupunta ng Ozin.
Because there's an audience right there. Doesn't matter if same yung sa perspective ng Ozin, we are here to hold events for the community. So, it doesn't matter if the content is the same, so idols, same. Doesn't matter. That's just a perspective. We're here to hold events. And it just so happens na almost every month may ano, January, February, tapos ang susunod nila August, and then I think August or November, December, mga ganun. That's okay. That's definitely okay. So, yeah. Maraming perspectives na ano dito, and we've just heard and seen 1, 2, 3, 4, and if this discussion expands further, we're looking forward to at least may tudos natin to sa organization ng mga event organizers. There's one, and I know, kasi being an event professional, have interacted with a lot of event tourism, MICE, meetings, incentives, conventions, exhibitions. There are many possibilities. It's just that sometimes we need a new concept kung nawawalan tayo ng gana. And sometimes we just need to get out of these events to experience something new. New experiences. Pero hindi tayo nagsasawa sa mga experiences na ginagawa natin. It's fine. Nobody forces you to change. Change is within.
Yes.
So, yun nga, no? Ang haba ng discussion natin. And again, thank you very much, JM, for being here. Go mention Anime Pilipinas. How do we access Anime Pilipinas?
For the latest news and information, log on to animepilipinas.com. And you could also follow us on our social media at Facebook, Twitter, at Anime Pilipinas, Instagram, mostly on events. And we hope to have more content, and we hope to see you around.
That wraps up another episode of Keepsakes, the podcast. New episodes can be heard on anchor.fm/keepsakes, Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, and Spotify. You can follow me on Twitter @JAgonoy. More updates will be posted on facebook.com/keepsakesbyJay. Leave your voice messages using the Anchor app available on Google Play and the App Store. Shout out to Lee Rosevere for the music. Thank you for listening to the podcast, and I hope you enjoyed it. Until next time.